Hello and welcome to Friday Night Nexus. This is the Fight Zone, glued to their seats, as you can see in the ring right now. That is one of the hottest commodities. He's a newcomer to American wrestling or to indie wrestling that isn't in Great Britain. This man is Nathan Cruz. And there is a man he has to face here tonight that the CEO, or the COO, whatever you want to say, just couldn't give up on the offer of getting the innovator of violence, Tommy Dreamer. This is Tommy Dreamer, a professional wrestling legend. If people say that this man isn't a legend, they are talking out their arse. This man is one of the creators of Extreme. You can tell this man is loved by the Fight Zone. If you remember last week, or 2 weeks ago, on Friday Night Nexus, Dean Ambrose went and claimed that he and the gods of Extreme are the innovators of Extreme. But this man literally bled to put the point across of who is the extremist guys in town. You have to feel kind of sorry for Nathan Cruz. Like, he is going to be in the ring against a veteran of the squared circle, and that man is Tommy Dreamer. You can see big elbow to the back of the head. Right away, Tommy Dreamer straight in there with the offense. When people thought of ECW, they just, like, the first thing that comes to head is a bunch of crazy mother effers just fighting in the ring with weapons, barbed wire, anything they could get their hands on. But if you think of the talent that came from ECW, you have the likes of Rey Mysterio, you have Lance Storm, Chris Jericho, Dean Malenko. There was all these different talents that were just amazing, and they ended up going on to become big deals in other companies. Like Chris Jericho, numerous time world champion, and he now resides in the Fight Zone. He is one of the hot commodities in Friday Night Nexus, and you just seen Tommy Dreamer. Oh my god, he just pile-drivered the life out of Nathan Cruz, but Nathan Cruz clings to life. Oh my god, look at this. As we said, he is one of the extreme icons beside Russian leg sweep shades of his best friend, Sandman. Where's again, Nathan Cruz, the faster and younger wrestler. Big Irish whip into the corner, he's turning Tommy Dreamer around, big punch to the lower spine. Oh my god. Double axe handle takedown by Tommy Dreamer. And a takedown there by Nathan Cruz. Right back at you, big arm drag by Tommy Dreamer. As we said, there's a wrestling ability coming straight into this match. And another side Russian leg sweep. Tommy Dreamer putting on a good show here, and Nathan Cruz, a newcomer to Friday Night Nexus, is fighting back against Tommy Dreamer. Not as good as he should be, but he's at least doing it. Both men rolling to the outside. Tommy Dreamer's going under. He is going to look for one of his toys, and it's a steel chair. Tommy Dreamer known for swinging that steel chair harder than any other man to step foot in the Fight Zone, in a wrestling ring, and you just heard it echo throughout the arena. There's people in the crowd, in the Fight Zone crowd, that just cannot believe how hard that sounded. And you can see Tommy Dreamer just awaiting the arrival of Nathan Cruz. Wait a second, double leg takedown by Tommy Dreamer. But what could Tommy Dreamer be going for here? He's got him up. Oh, he's going for a scoop slam. Nathan Cruz. Oh my god. Reverse DDT right on a steel chair. You can see the effect in Tommy Dreamer's eyes. Big drop kick to the back of the head. Nathan Cruz trying to get back into this. He's working the arm, smashing it off of that steel chair. See Nathan Cruz showing off, and they let Tommy Dreamer get a breather. Wait a second, Dreamer DDT. And Nathan Cruz is wearing a crimson mask. Surely that's from the steel chair, if not that brutal DDT. And the ref has rung the bell. The match is over. Tommy Dreamer dominated his first showing in Friday Night Nexus. But what makes a hardcore legend randomly appear in FNN? We're 2 seasons in. 2 seasons in, and Tommy Dreamer randomly shows up. Wait a second, he's got a message. He's getting a mic. Oh my, it did involve Ambrose. An ECW Extreme Rules match? No way. No way is he just invited Ambrose to the home of ECW, Viking Hall in Philadelphia. That is huge, but who's the origin of Extreme? We'll see him later on tonight. So this was an FNN Insider exclusive. You could see that the attacker was indeed Roman Reigns, and just the brutal attack, the giant spear to Matt Sydal. And if you need confirmation, look at that face. That is indeed Roman Reigns. And Matt Sydal is in competition later on tonight. Who knows what condition Sydal's going to be in. And who knows the punishment that Roman Reigns is going to get. So we are back in the fight zone, and looks like we are starting off, or we are continuing on, sorry, with Tommy End. This man is dangerous, and he's not dangerous just because of the potential seizure that could occur. He is dangerous because if you're running towards this man, he's not going to punch you, he's not going to take you down, he's going to kick your fucking head off. That is how extreme this man is. This man personifies FNN, and this is only his second match. And he's getting put up against, a nobody. We'll confirm his name before the match even starts. But he can't see him in the camera, but he's not even wearing shoes. How is he meant to compete against this man? This man is Tommy End, but we are just trying to confirm his name. Like, who even brought this man? Look at him, he's already been beaten up. He must have been in a bar or something. His shirt's all ripped, and I don't know. Right, oh my god, what kind of name is that? His name is, it's got the most mafia name ever. That man is Sonny Falcone. Who the hell is Sonny Falcone? But surely he's going to get beaten up. Just look at Tommy End. Not even showing effort. Why is Sonny? Sonny, keep away, Sonny. Oh, and there goes his head. Tommy End is just going to eat this man alive. He look, as we said, he's not even wearing shoes. He's not even wearing wrestling gear. Oh my god. Jumping knee takedown. Who knows what that was? Double knee takedown? I don't know. Tommy End of a big Irish whip. Check the size difference in these two men. Big shoulder barge by Tommy End. He's just, oh my god. Surely the referee's gonna finish this. And look at, listen to the fight zone. The fight zone love it. The fight zone love just the sheer thought. Big chop to the back of the head and a kick straight to the chest. If you remember, Tommy Ince showed up at FNN Crossroads, defeating the man known as Joey Ryan. I completely forgot his name because Tommy Ince got rid of him that fast. And Tommy End has been put in the sidelines. He is injured, there's no doubt about that. He was firstly beaten very, very fast. Then he was brutally attacked afterwards. Oh my god! Look at this. Oh no. Oh! Just wrenching the shoulder out of the socket. Or the wrist, in fact. The wrist connected to the rest of the forearm. Oh no. Oh no. Brain buster, oh my god, dropped right on his head. And just look at Tommy End, the sadistic bastard, sitting in the middle of the ring, proving his dominance. And Tommy End's getting nothing out of this match. Wait a second, wait a second. That's the octopus hold. The octopus hold. Oh my god, wait a second. I think Sonny Falcone might be out. In pure instinct, he tapped. The ref has rung the bell. Your winner of the match. And surely you couldn't expect the other guy to win. The winner of the match is indeed the man known as Tommy End. And he may have been the end of days for Sonny Falcone. His name is not even Falcone. You'd think he's a guy from Batman. But it's just, his name's Falcone. I do not know. So obviously it can't be his real name, like, it has to be a stage name or something, but that doesn't matter. This man is your winner of the match, and this man is Tommy freaking End. An octopus hold, where the hell did they pull an octopus hold from? And we're just going to go backstage to see the condition of Matt Sydal, and Jesus Christ, that looks like a broken nose. And there's Eric Bischoff. A 5-year blacklisted and a $50,000 fine. If you don't know what a blacklisting is from FNN, that is basically the term that means you will never get a contract for the next 5 years. And the reason for Roman Reigns not getting the contract is because, as you seen earlier on in the footage, he attacked Matt Sydal, and look at the condition that he left this man in. Clearly must have dislocated his shoulder, he beat up his face, broke his nose. It was the DDT onto the hard ground. If you've never been backstage in an arena like this, it's just a layer of carpet over pure concrete. It's not like a normal floor in a house or whatever, it's just pure concrete. And Matt Sydal is getting put up against the new shooting star champion of Friday Night Nexus, and that man is Buddy Murphy. Buddy Murphy, your shooting star champion. And Matt Sydal and Buddy Murphy don't have a problem. They're just getting put into this what you could claim is an exhibition match, which is might be Eric Bischoff's way of checking if Matt Sydal can still compete at the top level that he's competed at earlier in his career. But at the same time, like, it's a bit weird that Eric Bischoff would put Matt Sydal into a match right away. It confuses us, it must confuse you. If it doesn't confuse you, then you must not have a brain cell. But, oh well, not insulting the viewers, I'm just stating facts. Buddy Murphy, Eric Bischoff's new favourite, and Buddy Murphy doesn't really seem fazed. He's acknowledged it in the past. Both of these men shaking hands, great respect for each other. Fight Zone going crazy, the bell has been rung. Buddy Murphy ducking under, wait a second, neckbreaker. Oh, and you can see the force of that neckbreaker on. See how slow Matt Sydal was to get up there. But Buddy Murphy playing it respectfully, collar and elbow tie up, nice headlock by Matt Sydal. He's wrenching the head a little bit. Oh, headlock takedown. Oh, wrenching the neck. Nice takedown there. and a headlock by Buddy Murphy now. Both these men paying the respectful game, and that is a similar move to a key lock. It's more just an elbow-to-elbow lock. Not sure of the real official name, and a great takedown there. That was like an inverted Russian leg sweep in a way there. Oh! The wrestling ability keeps going. If you look at Buddy Murphy, he's keeping it a bit... He's keeping it a bit good. He's not putting too much offense on. Look at this, jumping under with a second big DDT, and that kind of proves it right there. Matt Sydal can still compete at a top level, and Buddy Murphy's just realized that he's going for a super kick to the gut. Matt Sydal says no. Look at Matt Sydal. Nope. Sit out powerbomb, Buddy Murphy. Great. Great maneuver right there. Great instinct. Oh. Two count, basically a two count, or a 1.9, 1 in 979 milliseconds, something like that. Big missile drop kick from the second rope. Buddy Murphy's going for the pin, trying to finish this early one. Oh, just a one count. Buddy Murphy, if you look at the frustration in his face, he just wants to end this early to not do any more damage to Matt Sydal, and a big super kick to the gut, and it looked like a slap. A slap to Matt Sydal, perhaps, because he doesn't, like, as I say, he doesn't want to damage Sydal a bit too much. Oh, but Matt Sydal straight back with an open hand punch, or a closed hand punch, sorry, straight to the face. Now Buddy Murphy's just swinging for the heavens. Evan Bourne, Matt Sydal, sorry, right there. He's going by Matt Sydal now. Wait, Matt Sydal, Fisherman Buster! Fisherman Buster. Matt Sydal should have went for the pin. That would have been a three. Buddy Murphy, big forearm straight to the face. Matt Sydal with a great arm drag. And wait a second, Sydal, big arm drag now. Tilt the world arm drag, should we say. Sydal, nice snap mail there. Big drop kick to the back, right to the back of the head. You can see that force. Oh my god. As you can see, this man wasn't called airborne. He was called airborne for a reason, sorry, and it's because he can contort himself in the air, kind of like a plane. And that's exactly what he did. Big super kick to the gut. Wait, there was Buddy Murphy doing. Oh my god. He went for a first rope. Foot drop. Big stomp. That's the easier way to say it. Oh, wait a second, sit out spine buster, going for the pin. One, this could be it. Two, no, just a two. Buddy Murphy wearing a little colourful attire this episode of Friday Night Nexus. You can catch us here every week, every Friday. We're usually not late like other universe modes out there. Never ever. Buddy Murphy going up top. Oh, big elbow. Perhaps damaged that elbow. As you can see, he wears an elbow pad for a reason. Obviously a past injury. I can't really confirm that what the injury was, but it does involve that part of the arm, just judging from the positioning of the arm pad. And you can see Buddy Murphy toying with Matt Sydal a little bit. Go for a spinning kick. Matt Sydal might be angry. Clearly angry. Oh no, he's got a fisherman Buster once again. Fisherman Buster. Matt Sydal standing shooting star press, or standing moonsault, sorry. That was very impressive, but Buddy Murphy straight back to his feet. Buddy Murphy doesn't even care. Uh oh, bouncing off the ropes. Falcon Arrow. Oh my god, I've not seen Buddy Murphy do that before. Very good, beautiful Falcon Arrow. Jawbreaker by Matt Sydal. Punch straight to the face. Wait a second. Reverse tilt the world DDT. Matt Sydal bowing to the crowd as usual, indication that he wants to finish this match. But when will he decide enough is enough? It's about time to get this over with. Who knows? It's up to Sydal. Sydal discretion. Oh, he's going for those rapid elbows in the corner. Oh my god. German suplex right into a pin. One, two, three, no. Mad Sydal nearly get a pin over the Shooting Star champion, and that would have made him one of the top contenders for that championship. Oh, where is he going? He's going up top. Or he is up top. I mean, what's he waiting for? Oh, go for a Dragon Rana, but no, he just missed it. But perhaps he did damage to Buddy Murphy in the process, just hitting off the back of his head. Buddy Murphy rolling out, blowing to the crowd, potentially getting a breather, but a big kick to the gut and a second roundhouse one. Buddy Murphy showing no care in the world. These are just two friends. Oh my god, a discus forearm. As I said, these are just two friends fighting just because they've been put into a match, and they are giving it their all. They are giving some showing here at Friday Night Nexus, episode 39, Big Brain Buster. That is the Murphy's Law. It does have a custom name, and it is Murphy's Law. The law has been put in place in Matt Sydal. You fought the law, and the law won. Your winner, the Shooting Star champion, Buddy Murphy. You just seen the Fight Zone are unglued. They are on their feet. They are going crazy. Your winner of the match is Buddy freaking Murphy. As he just proved, as it wasn't a one-time thing, that win over Mark Andrews wasn't just because there was a championship on the line. He is willing and fighting whenever he bloody can. And the Fight Zone is going mental for the winner. Oh my god, I'm going mental. That was amazing. And the only thing we have left for this episode of Friday Night Nexus is the origin of Extreme. And this isn't the origin of Extreme, just so I can see. There's a man that spoke badly about Extreme for quite a while. Obviously until now, where he is the GM of a company that personifies modern day Extreme in professional wrestling. This man is Eric Bischoff, the FNN general manager. Obviously, formerly a part of the Black Label, because it seems the Black Label crumbled due to constant attacks by Baron Corbin, by Samuel Zayn, by the, what, I don't know, the Corbin and Zayn conspiracy. That's the only name we have for it at the moment. And it caused Drew Galloway to go crazy. It caused Jack Jester to be attacked. It caused Cesaro to be attacked. And it only left a broken Eric Bischoff and a broken Drew Galloway. We are going to let the general manager talk. Let's get straight on in. A Leave the Country match? Well, he has always had a problem with backseat bookers. Yeah, where is he? The origin of Extreme. This is the old ECW music and the FNN Season 1 theme song that we used. It's a cover of the original Extreme song. But, oh my, no way. That is the final ECW champion, Rhino. And perhaps it was completely honest, Tommy Dreamer was honest. That man, knowing, is Paul Heyman. He is the origin of Extreme, the owner of ECW. Paul Heyman is here in Friday Night Nexus. And there it is, another invite to Viking Hall. Eric Bischoff getting the hell out of here. And I'm afraid we need to get the hell out of here. This is it for Friday Night Nexus. Thank you for watching.